One day, for some reason unknown, I came to this world. It was winter, with a lot of snow. It was January. That's why I was named Jan. I didn't know why that happened. It was a moment like any moment. It wasn't important for any known reason. Just like that, one simple day, in the cold of winter, in the white of snow, I noticed I was alive. I came to existence. It was a funny thought. And the days passed by. I existed. Suddenly one day, I started to think that there was something I had to do. Soon afterwards, I was not satisfied with just being in life. Suddenly I had a strong impression that there had to be a reason why I was alive. Nothing had sense anymore. It started to bother me. that stupid lack of purpose of my existence. I simply couldn't be like I used to be before, and for the first time, I felt unhappy. I realized then that I could feel.
I'm in heaven, and my heart beats so that I can hardly speak.
Obviously, I was a creature of some kind, existing in this world for a reason nobody knew anything about. But still, I had to do something. Soon I became angry, since my world was profoundly shaken, and there was nobody to blame. That moment, I realized that there had to be a way to get answers, and it was my quest in this world to find them. Otherwise, I would always stay in that unpleasant state of nothingness. That was how I decided to go away. The problem was that I didn't really know what I was looking for. But I decided to believe deeply that I would recognize it when I found it. That was comforting. Suddenly, I felt full of confidence. I was on my way even before I started to move. It was as if I was already there, even though I had no idea where that was supposed to be. In the blink of an eye, I found myself walking down the streets of some foreign places, listening to the sound of words spoken in languages I didn't understand, lying in the sun as if everywhere and everything was home. The world opened before me like a spring blossom, as if the only reason for it to exist was to embrace me, me. Jan the Traveler. And that was how, for the first time, I felt free. When that happened, I knew it was freedom I was looking for. But there was a minor issue about freedom. In a while, I realized that it was very difficult to stay free for a longer period of time. And in order to keep your freedom, you had to move fast. In order to keep your freedom, you had to learn how to be faster than that strange habit of mind to bond or to attach to places, things, living creatures, or whatever gave you comfort. That was how I started to run. I started to race with my mind. Racing mind became my way of life, and for the moment, it was satisfying. It wasn't an easy road, but it was mine, and it made my existence possible. While I could win my own race, I was a champion of the world. And I could go on like that forever, all the way, till the end. End. That was a new thought that occupied my mind. That was how I first realized that everything that began had to end just the same. And that for every living creature, there was a moment when it had to die. But that didn't scare me. I wasn't afraid of life or death. But sometimes I was a little tired on my endless roads. Sometimes I was a little lost. And that was how I realized I was alone. Strange thought I observed. It never bothered me before. I didn't even know what I was missing. Yet sometimes I suffered unimaginable pain. Thank you. that was how I discovered that there was a heart in every living creature. A place within that cried out and reached, and from which a little voice softly spoke. That was how I realized that there was God. So it was you, I thought. It was you who knew all the answers. Where are you? Show yourself. Why do I exist? But he was silent. Sometimes he was so silent that I started to doubt he was listening at all. Sometimes I would even doubt that God, my friend, was there. But then, something completely unexpected happened. When I thought that God, my only friend, had left me, suddenly he showed me the most beautiful of all things. It was love. One day I saw her in a crowded place. She shouted something in a language I didn't understand. I saw her eyes. I didn't know her name, but she was mine forever. There were no words to say. No words in the world. I loved her so much that for the first time in my life I was afraid. So one day I went away. I didn't know why or where. I just knew that somehow the only way to have her was to lose her. And there I was again, on my streets, my roads, my kingdom under the sky. As time passed, I forgot everything I knew or believed before. I became a stranger. It was who I was. My name was not important, since there was no one to call me by my name. I was a traveler, alone on my road. A son of God, I was free, clean and empty. A piece of wood. And that was how I found myself here. Me, myself, in this room, in this place, in this body, captured. There is no escape, neither from this room, neither from this body, neither from this self. I am captured in these arms and legs and guts. It is interesting how this consciousness is glued to this body. Time is like water. It flows. Sometimes it drops and sometimes it floods everything. I let myself float. I let it carry me where it wants. I'm floating and I'm fine. Today I understand I will not do anything great. I will not achieve great things because I am not a great one. I'm not a poet. But for some reason, today I find that beautiful. Today I float in that too. I remember I used to fantasize. I dreamed about some true life, about some better world. But it seems I have forgotten everything about that. I have no choice but to keep going. The other day I noticed that if I looked at the sun and then closed my eyes, behind my eyelids I would see a face. I think it's her face. The way I remember it. The only one that exists, which I forget. Then it went, then again forget. And it went again. I remember how we used to sit together by the ocean. There was silence and the sea and she sitting next to me. Nothing else. Sometimes I think that I invented that too. That it was a dream, maybe, but I don't care. It is all I've got. I remember how she used to laugh loudly, with her mouth open, when she was making fun of me because I knew nothing about geography. All these little things are drifting towards me now. Maybe because it is spring. How it happens. How it happens that you become a stranger wherever you find yourself. Even in your own body. Then you try to run away from that solitude. You run to the places where it is normal to be alone. To foreign places. Where it becomes bearable. I'm not sure if I still exist. I know nothing. Even that stuff I thought I knew before. I came to the end. Maybe I am dead. God, I called him, but he gave no answer. Did I disappoint you? He didn't respond. What a cruel God you are. If I have eyes, I would cry. What if little voice of God was mine? What if I am God? What if I have to answer all the questions myself? And does it mean I am responsible for everything else in the world? No, that cannot be. It cannot be. No, I'm surely not God. Oh, thank God I'm not God. Thank God I'm just a puppet. A puppet. I realize this now for the first time. I am a wooden puppet on the strings in someone's hands. I'm going through my life attached to someone or something. Is that God that is holding the strings? Is it my destiny? Am I manipulated by it, or it follows my lead? But what difference does it truly make? I remember how we lay together listening to the ocean. I remember the happiness I felt. I remember how happiness ran through my body. That was the only important thing I have ever done. Loving you. That was my highest achievement. You must know that. I remember now. I know everything that can be known. There is nothing else to look for.